Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Tevron here, and welcome to another episode of Friday Night Magic. This week, we are once again in the teamer colors, however, we're playing a bit different of a deck, a more dedicated ramp deck, a deck that I have played in the past and have really enjoyed, an updated version of Geist Ramp. For those of you that don't know what Geist Ramp is supposed to do, I have made a video of this on one of my previous FNMs. I will link to that right here so that you can watch that if you would like to. However, we're going to go through the list and I will explain what is going on. The list has changed a bit with the new cards. We are running two Jaddy offshoots. This is a great way to gain life and just hold off aggressive decks, keeping you at a comfortable life total until you can do your thing. We are running two Fall of the Titans, whose surge ability is really significant and can do some amazing things in this deck, especially in conjunction with the namesake card of the deck, Geist Blast, whose primary ability is not the dealing of two damage to target creature or player, but rather the exiling from the graveyard to copy target instant or sorcery spell we control. So we can get some huge effects from a lot of our instants and sorceries, Fall of the Titans being one of the better ones. We are now running two Primal Druid, a 0-3 that can just hold the ground really good, and when it dies, it ramps us for a basic land. Two Rolling Thunder, just another X spell to throw in the deck. We were originally running three, I think, so I've gone down to two as we're doing a few other things with the new cards. Two Pilgrim's Eye, additional mana fixing for the deck, and we are running a few Emerge creatures, so it plus the Primal Druid are good synergy with that. One Kozilek's Return. We now have a significant number of ways to get it to exile itself and do damage from the graveyard. Previously, it was only It was only Ulamog in the deck who could actually do that. Now we have other things that can. Again, we're running the three Geist Blast. Three pieces of the puzzle to help us find our significant instants and or sorceries. And now that the card is fixed and we can actually take the instants that we want to, that is rather good too. Two Radiant Flames as an additional board sweeper and control card versus aggro decks. Three Nissa's Pilgrimage as the first of our ramp spells. This will allow us to get the vast amount of lands into play that we need to make this deck function properly. Three Explosive Vegetation, a better ramp spell, as it puts two basics directly onto the battlefield, and it also allows us to fix our mana. Two Pour Over the Pages for raw card drawing and utility. One Green Warden of Murasa, because it's always best to be able to do it again. One Part of the Water Veil, because it's absolutely busted with a Geist Blast. One Crush of Tentacles. Again, board control can also give us a threat in the form of an 8-8 blue octopus token. And if you have both Crush of Tentacles and Green Warden of Murasa, then you can crush forever. Just crush, recast Green Warden, return crush to your hand, so on and so forth. One Nissa's Renewal as our final ramp spell and also a bit of life gain to hopefully keep us alive. One Chandra Flamecaller, because she is also board control, as well as card draw, and can also end the game all on her own if it comes to that. We are running one Wretched Griff, the first of our Emerge creatures. Just good utility. The actual casting cost of the card will allow Kozilek's Return to be triggered from the graveyard if it is there, and the drawing a card is also nice. Two Elder Deep Fiend. I am in love with this guy. He controls the board. He is a flash threat. He's just really, really good. And the last of our Emerge creatures is one Vexing Scuttler, who will allow us to recur instants and sorceries from our graveyard. So that is good as well. And finally, the Ula Daddy. I think he needs no introduction. There he is. He's in the deck. Our mana base is 6 islands, 5 mountains, 10 forests, and 2 evolving wilds. That's enough deck tech. Let's shuffle up and play. Alrighty. Well, if we're playing against aggro, this is definitely a good hand. We don't have any ramp, though. I'm a little reluctant to keep this. Though we do have three lands, I'm going to go ahead and risk it. Alright, swamp from the opponent. Hopefully we can draw a pilgrimage or something relatively quickly to start casting our large creatures here. Either that, or hopefully our opponent doesn't put us under a ton of pressure. That would also be rather nice. Alright, all we know about the opponent thus far is they have black in their deck. We continue to draw large casting cost spells. Hopefully we live long enough to make use of those. Alrighty. Looks like we are against vampires. We probably should expend one of these cards to kill that guy. I think that we will pass, and hopefully they will overextend before attacking, and we can Kozilek's Return and get more than one creature. I may actually let it hit us once just to see if I can get more than one creature from the Kozilek's Return. Yeah, I'm going to do that. We're going to take four here. Hopefully they will play something that we can kill. And they did. Good deal. Alright, we will Kozilek's Return. So we'll wipe the board here and get the Kozilek's Return into our yard, where it needs to be. Evolving Wilds is good. We are in need of blue manas. So we will go ahead and get that. That will make our Radiant Flames better, although we do need at least one more blue in play to cast either of these spells. And we'll just pass back. Really, really want to draw some ramp soon. Even if it's only a Pilgrim's Eye or a Druid. Incorrigible Youths. Well, we're going to take some damage from that, going to 12. We will be able to Radiant Flames it away. Alright, we finally got an Explosive Vegetation. And I think I'm going to risk taking another 4 here so that we can go ahead and start ramping. So we will Explosive Veg. And I will get 2 islands here. Blue is a more important color than red in the deck. And we already have 2 red, which is the bare minimum that we need to operate. We need at least 3 to part the water veil, with Awaken. And we need 1 more to cast a Geist Blast and copy it. So, alright, going to 8 here. Hopefully they will deploy some more creatures. Looks like they are being more conservative. Well, we're going to start by poring over the pages. All right, then we will untap. What have we got? Yeah, we will untap, can't quite see, a mountain and a forest, confirm, and we have to discard a card, so we will discard, I think we will discard Ulamog at this point. We can potentially get him back later if necessary. Then we will play our land. And we're going to go ahead and Radiant Flames to kill the board. Actually, I missequenced that. I should have held the land because I'm going to play a Jaddy offshoot and we could have got a life gain out of that. That is my mistake. Hopefully that doesn't come back to bite us where we only die by 1 point of damage. All right, Fiery Temper, probably going upstairs. It is. So we should be at 6 if I had sequenced my plays correctly there. They're the blood mad vampire. Luckily, it is not haste. All right, so let's gain a life here. And then I think we are going to go ahead. We don't have a Geist Blast in the yard. No, we don't. We do have enough to just hard cast Elder Deep Fiend, though. So I am going to do that. We're going to pass. I'm going to let them attack with this and then flash in Elder Deep Fiend to block it. If it dies, I'll just go ahead and block with the offshoot, most likely. We're going to go ahead and pause. Luckily, the game is not being rude to me and not letting me pause this time. And then we will tap down all of the opponent's red mana because we can't get all of their black. Five damage to the board. That's not necessary. Thank you for asking, though. If they have murder in hand, they can take care of the Elder Deep Fiend. They decided to leave the game. We're going to continue playing. We will block this dude. And hopefully this will be the turning point for us. There's another Rolling Thunder. I think we've got this. We are going to part the Water Bell with Awaken. And Awaken onto this forest. Then we're going to swing for 5. Untap, swing for 11, and we got Rolling Thunder to finish them off. So the little mistake with the sequencing with Jaddy Offshoot did not come back to make us sad. Doesn't mean we shouldn't have played it that way, though. Could have been significant. Alright, and we will Rolling Thunder for 6. All to your face, and on to the next one. Alright. I'm less happy with this hand as we don't really have any sweepers, so I'm going to redraw. This is better. I still would prefer to have a third land in hand, but I think this is keepable between the offshoot and the Primal Druid. So we're going to need to fetch for green with the Evolving Wilds, or not, never mind. The game was kind enough to let us top deck a forest, so that's just peachy. Next turn, we will probably just fetch with the Evolving Wilds so that we can for sure cast Pilgrimage on turn 3. If we top deck another non-Evolving Wilds land, we may just play out the Primal Druid. Looks like our opponent is on Rakdos here. Could be another vampire deck. As is, we're going to fetch and gain a bit of life. We'll fetch for an island with this. That way we'll have all three of our colors. We rarely want to fetch for forests with anything that isn't Nissa's Pilgrimage because all it can get is forests in the deck. There are times when you will want to get forests with Explosive Vegetation or Pilgrim's Eye or something like that. But in general, you don't want to do that. We've got Olivia's Dragoon over here. It can gain flying, so that is an evasive threat. However, our Jaddy Offshoot is padding our life total nicely. We are going to go ahead and Pilgrimage, getting us 2 forests as we do not yet have Spell Mastery. Then next turn, we were lucky enough to draw an Explosive Vegetation, so that turn is planned out. Jaddy is doing a really good job of keeping us at a nice, healthy life total there. Looks like our Jaddy is getting fiery tempered. Yep, opponent is tired of us gaining life, but at least that is another 3 life that the Jaddy gained us by having this fiery temper go to it instead of to our face. Alrighty. So just the Dragoon is on the board still for the opponent. We will Explosive, and we will get an Island and a Mountain again. Island and a Mountain. And we will Evolving Wilds for a third Island. Alright. Good deal. We will be able to cast Vexing Scuttler next turn if we want to. We may do that to get our Explosive Vegetation back, just depending on what we see from the opponent here. Then again, we may just Pieces of the Puzzle and then Surge Fall of the Titans to deal with these. We're going to be taking 6 damage here, and this guy is going to be growing to a 5-2. It gets +1/+1 when it deals damage to a player. If they play the red enchantment, can't remember the name of it, Stenzia Banquet or something like that, we could be in more trouble. And we are in more trouble because Incorrigible Youths is joining the fray. So, let's see. We'll probably be killing these two next turn. I think we've got the mana for that. Although, if Pieces of the Puzzle shows us a Radiant Flames, that will be much nicer to deal with this board. Alright, well, let us Pieces of the Puzzle, leaving open all 3 colors of mana in case we do get a Radiant Flames. And we got 2 Radiant Flames. You like apples? Well, how you like those apples? Let's go ahead and Radiant Flames for the full package there. Then we will Forest and Primal Druid. Good deal. What else did we put into the yard? Pilgrim's Eye and another offshoot, as well as Chandra. Would have liked to had Chandra, but those are the breaks. Firecraft going to our face. Looks like our opponent is going to try to burn us out. Fall of the Titans is nice for us. Let's go ahead and Pieces of the Puzzle again. See if we can find something to end the game. Pour over the pages. I will take the Geist Blast as well. Putting it into the yard is something that we could do. And we will go ahead and pour over the pages. Alright, Nissa's Renewal is a good draw. I can't remember if we've played a land this turn. So we will untap an Island and a Mountain. Island and Mountain. Confirm. And we will be discarding a Geist Blast. There we go. And we haven't played a land, so we will play this for us. That will give us the opportunity to Geist Blast if it is necessary. We probably will Geist Blast the opponent's face at the end of their turn if they don't present us with any other targets for it. And then if we survive to our turn, we will be gaining 14 life because we're going to copy Nissa's Renewal, which will then allow us to probably kill them the following turn. Alright, so we do have a copy for our, or a target rather, for our Geist Blast. We will take care of that guy. And we are going to Nissa's Renewal and pause. And we will copy it with Geist Blast. So 6 lands and 14 life seems pretty good to me. Get all of these non-forest lands first. Confirm. Second copy. All the rest of the non-forest lands. Confirm. And skip attack. right, so we're at a bajillion lands and above 20 life, and our opponent's at 4 lands. Seems like a decent position to be in. Alright, Collective Defiance. Are they going to Wheel of Fortune themselves or just hit us for 3? Okay. Oh, they're Wheel of Fortuning us too. Okay, that's fine. We'll just kill them with Part the Water Veil. I'm perfectly happy with that. I mean, it's kind of sad losing that stuff, but that's just the way it goes sometimes. We will part the Water Veil with Awaken. We're going to awaken onto a forest. That is fine. And then we will pause. And we will Geist Blast onto the part of the Water Veil. And again, that is fine to tap. Awaken onto, say, a mountain this time. And that's the game. Should be. 12 damage twice is more than 20. We'll just attack with the Primal Druid. Send a message. And then we'll take our extra turn. Don't mind if I do. And I will see you guys in the next one. Thanks for the Titan Strength. Alright, we're a bit light on colors, but we are very heavy on ramp and survivability, so let's keep this. See if we can get there. We do need to draw one more land to be able to start ramping, but we have this Primal Druid and Jatty Offshoot to hold the ground for us, hopefully. See what the opponent's doing here. Okay, so Swamp for the opponent. Very good. Radiant Flames for us, also quite nice. Play out our Druid, and hopefully we will either top deck a land next turn, or have this Primal Druid die. Okay, white and black could mean any number of things. Could be allies slash enchantments. Skip attack, no need to swing. Could be a controlling deck. Don't really know yet. Alright, so it is ramp of some sort. And we see Abzan colors so far. Would like to hit one of my lands. Please let me jump on this party. Doesn't happen. Skip attack. Let's not founder here at 2 lands and play for 2 awfully long, please. There's Gisela. She's going to start beating our face down. And still stuck. Could have attacked in, hoping they will block with the Gisela. It's not going to happen. So now we're on a 2-turn clock. And we're probably just dead. I can't really remove the Gisela because I don't have enough lands. So, yep, that is a thing that can happen. Hopefully we'll get a little bit luckier in the next game. I'll see you there. Alright, again we're in sort of the same position, where we have a pilgrimage, and we don't have either of our second colors, but we do have an offshoot. I'm going to draw again this time, and we can't keep that. That is better, we'll keep this. So we will be fetching for a mountain, Then we can play a primal druid next turn and a pieces of the puzzle the turn after. And hopefully this mulligan to six will not hurt us too awfully bad. Would like to hit a Nissa's Pilgrimage off of the pieces of the puzzle. That would be very good. Alright, the second pieces of the puzzle. Well, we'll play out our Primal Druid. Duskwatch Recruiter. So we're playing against something that seems to be aggressive. Alright. Nice to draw a fourth land. So now I would not mind hitting Explosive Vegetation either off of this pieces. Well, we didn't get either of those, but we got some more card draw, so I guess that's okay. And we won't be swinging. We are planning to block. Hamlet Captain. So it's white-green humans, seems to be, at any case. And they just don't attack. They just, I guess, think it's not really worth it. We will pieces of the puzzle before we play our land, just to see what we hit. Come on, ramp spells, please. And we didn't get ramp spells. I will take the Geist Blast and the Crush of Tentacles, though. And then we'll play our land out. And again, we won't attack. They attack here. Luckily, we can probably get our Primal Druid to die. The Hamlet Captain will make this guy a 3-3. We can block it and then let it ramp us a little bit. All right, they are swinging. So Hamlet Captain's going to trigger. Duskwatch Recruiter will become a 3-3. And we will martyr our Primal Druid. Thank you for your sacrifice. Yes, I would. I want a mountain. Alright, activating Duskwatch Recruiter. So that thing is going to flip then because they did not play a spell on this turn and neither did we. And we're Militia Captain. We are going to... I don't want to use the green mana, thank you. We're going to Geist Blast it in response to the flip trigger. Get it off of the board. Alright. Alright, third time's the charm. Ramp spells, please. And again we miss. Well, we're going to take some Radiant Flames. Seems like the best choices out of those. And now we've got two Geist Blasts in the yard. So our opponent knows we've got these Radiant Flames. So they will be very careful about what they play out here. We will probably be very liberal in playing them ourselves. We want to keep our life total high if possible. Alright, just the Militia Captain then. Well, we are going to start by casting Pour Over the Pages. And finally, we drew a ramp spell. So we're going to untap Forest and Mountain. Confirm. And we are going to discard... probably just Rolling Thunder at this point. I like the rest of our cards better than that. Then we're going to just Radiant Flames that Militia Captain away. Hopefully get our opponent to deploy some more. And play our Forest. We're going to Nissa's Renewal next turn. Ah, that's why they didn't play anything. They've got Heron's Grace Champion in hand, and it has Flash. Actually, we may Crush of Tentacles next turn, trying to build up more land so that we can Geist Blast the Nissa's Renewal. This will give us an 8-8 Octopus because we're going to play Primal Druid to give it Surge. Alright, Nissa, Voice of Zendikar. Yep, I do think that Crush of Tentacles is going to be the play here. Nissa's Pilgrimage is good as well. So we could just Pilgrimage for the Surge. I think that's what we'll do. That's a better choice than the Primal Druid. So 1, 2, 3, because we have Spell Mastery. And we'll go ahead and Surge this Crush. Bouncing all non-land permanents and giving us an 8-8 Octopus. And hopefully that thing will stay alive to help us win this game. Alright, Duskwatch Recruiter. Opponent is short a land to be able to activate it this turn, so I guess they're just going to play out a Militia Captain. We do have this Radiant Flames. But I think what we're going to do is Nissa's Renewal with a Geist Blast here. Let's start by attacking. Don't really have to worry about the damage coming from the opponent at this point, since we're going to be gaining 14 life. Alright, play our Forest. Then we will play Nissa's Renewal and pause. And let's go ahead and Geist Blast this bad boy. Alright, this is going to get all the rest of the basic lands out of our deck. So that's good to know. No use in wasting the Nissa's Pilgrimage. We'll save it to perhaps give a Titan's Fall of the Titans or a Crush of Tentacles Surge if we recur the Crush from the graveyard. Collective effort. So bye-bye Octopus. These guys will grow. Luckily we still have this Radiant Flames here. Oh, they didn't escalate it to get rid of our Octopus. Huh. That seems questionable. Even though it would have stopped them from getting in 3 damage this turn, I think that was definitely a better play. So we get to keep our Octopus. Good deal. Well, let's start by poring over the pages. Alright, we'll untap an island in a forest. And we'll discard the Kozilek's Return. Then, we're going to Radiant Flames to wipe their side of the board. Confront the unknown, okay? So this guy will stay alive. That's fine. We're going to swing with our Octopus. Alright, they're conserving their life total here. We should have them on the next turn, though. Geist blasting part the water veil. We will go ahead and play out the rest of our hand here. Pilgrim's Eye, and we do not. There's nothing left for it to get. Primal Druid. Come on now. There we go. And Jetty Offshoot. And even if they have a land plus Planar Outburst here, we still should win this game. But it looks like they do not. Alright, well, let's part the water veil with Awaken. Awaken onto a forest. That's fine. Pause. Oops, wrong pile. And we will Geist Blast it. Copy this. That's fine. And awaken onto this mountain. And crash in there. Archangel Avacyn is not going to help you. We've got 3 turns of attacks with all this damage coming. Swing. There we go. Confirm. Alright, soaking up 8 here, so we're going to have to attack one more turn to get this job done. And looks like they closed their client. Guess we can give the benefit of the doubt. Maybe they just got disconnected from the server, but I feel like they closed their client. No matter. I will see you guys in the next one. Alright, I don't think that this hand is keepable. There's just not enough going on. This one's still a little iffy, but I'm going to keep it because we got the Primal Druid plus the Pilgrim's Eye. Again, we're going to need a third land to actually get going here. Alright, that's not a third land. We still have a few draws to get there, though. Ah, there's land number 3. Nice to see you. We'll make this game a lot more pleasant, I think. So we can play a Pilgrim's Eye next turn, unless we top deck a Nessus Pilgrimage, and then we'll most likely be playing that. Wondering if our opponent is playing a Prowess deck here. Or one of the Thermo Alchemists, I think they're called. The 2-mana 0/3 guys that tap to deal a damage to the opponent and then untap if you play an instant or sorcery. Those have been a bit popular lately. Alright. Looks like our opponent may be missing their third land drop here. Good deal. Well, luckily we have our land drop. So let's play out our Pilgrim's Eye. And we will be getting an island. That way we can cast Pieces of the Puzzle next turn. Confirm. And we will hold back just in case they have something to play that can attack. Galvanic Bombardment. Alright, shame. Killing our Pilgrim's Eye. Looks like we won't be emerging our Deep Fiend onto that thing. All right, well, let us put together the puzzle, shall we? Again, we are looking for ramp spells, and luckily we found one. Good deal. All right, your turn. Fevered Visions. All right, this is looking more like a Jeskai tutelage deck with the Fevered Visions hitting there. So let's go ahead and ramp. And we will get our second island and second mountain. And pass the turn. Going to be taking two here from the Fevered Visions, and we're going to have to discard as well. I think at this point we're going to discard one Rolling Thunder. Oath of Jace. All right, I'm fine with that as long as there's not a Sphinx's Tutelage out at the same time. I think we may be playing our Elder Deep Fiend this next turn. Looks like they're having to discard two. See what they have discarded here. Part of the Water Veil, Comparative Analysis. They've got Geist Blast in there, the same as us. All right, what we are going to do is just pass. Skip attack. Draw from the Fevered Visions. Then we will discard the Geist Blast. And we also have to discard a second card. We'll discard our other Primal Druid. And we will respond. Luckily, they have Oath of Jace, so we can do something in their actual upkeep here. So we're going to emerge our Deep Fiend on our Primal Druid. That is fine. And we will tap them out. Comparative Analysis in response, that's fine. At least they will not be dealing with our Elder Deep Fiend this turn. I do. Let's go ahead and get another island. Alrighty. Drawing from their Fevered Visions there. Going to have to discard again, it looks like. Discarding a lot. Geist Blast, Deccan Stone, Morganic Galvanic Bombardments. Well, we are going to swing for five. Confirm. And then we're going to Renewal. Unfortunately, we don't have quite enough mana to Geist Blast it as well. So we will get two islands and a mountain. And it'll be your go, friend. Nice life bump from the Nissa's Renewal there. Also giving us enough to potentially kill the opponent next turn. So they're going to be probably, yep, exiling our Elder Deep Fiend here. That's fine. Let's see. We'll do some mana counting when it comes to our turn. Okay, we have got 11, 12. So if we take away three, we have nine. Two to start at seven. We don't quite have enough to kill them with a Rolling Thunder that is Geist Blasted, but we can pilgrimage and then do some other things. Let's not tap all of our green mana, please. we will get our full three since we have spell mastery. And then, how many Geist Blasts do we have in the yard? Just the one. Let's pour over the pages first. Alright, well, we will untap a forest. We'll just untap two forests, that's fine. And then we have to discard. We will discard a forest. And now we'll go ahead and Fall of the Titans for the full five. I think I'm just going to do it to our opponent's face. Finish. I don't want to do damage to the Planeswalker. I want to do it to our opponent's face. And then we will again discard a forest. Holding on to the Radiant Flames just in case, though I think it's kind of a moot point here. And they will need to be able to counter two spells to stop us from killing them this next turn, I think. Right, another Fevered Visions, and they're completely tapped out, so good game. We will Rolling Thunder and copy it with Geist Blast. Getting milled for some here. As long as they don't take all of our cards away, we will win the game. Alrighty then. Well, we will play our land, and then we will Rolling Thunder for 9. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That is fine. And then we will go ahead and Geist Blast it, even though we didn't actually need to. We had enough damage to kill them even without the copy. And I will see you guys in the next one. Alright. Well, we don't have early game as far as holding the board with Jaddy and Primal Druid, but we do have a ramp spell and all of our colors. Plus we do have a Radiant Flame, so I think this is a definite keep. Hopefully we're not up against Simic Tempo here. That could be a rather troublesome matchup, I think. We'll drop our mountain. See what's going on here. Right, it is looking like Simic. We may be seeing a Rattle Chains or an Infiltrator getting flashed in on our instep. We will deploy our island. And it's a telling time, okay? So perhaps it's not an aggro deck then. Could be a Sultai control deck that has just not hit its black mana yet. Alright, another island. So I'm thinking of the opponent is holding up counter spells. So we will pass back. Oh, there is a Nebelgast Herald. So maybe they're not holding up counter spells, but we're going to go ahead and kill that guy while we have the opportunity. Lumbering Falls. Does appear that they are a Simic Tempo deck with a lot of flash creatures and tricks. Let's see if we can resolve an Explosive Vegetation. Looks like it's going to happen. That's good. Well, we will get A mountain and an island is our usual routine. There is bounding crisis. So we're going to be taking 3 to the face here. Probably just be playing Wretched Griff next turn to draw a card and give us a presence on the board. Don't quite have enough mana to be flashing in our Elder Deep Fiend as of yet. Alright, make our land drop and play our Wretched Griff with the full cost. Getting shriveled, that's fine, we still get to draw our card. It's an on-cast ability, not an enters the battlefield ability. Hello, Jatty. Would like to have had you way earlier, but I'm not going to sweat it too awfully much. Going down to 14. Hopefully they are not holding just a glut of counterspells on us here. Vexing Scuttler is nice. Let's play our Jatty, or try to. Then we will play a forest. Gain ourselves a life. And pass the turn, planning on flashing in Elder Deep Fiend. Alright, got a Pack Guardian there, did not discard to make a wolf, so we're going to try to flash in Elder Deep Fiend here. If it gets countered, that should tap them out to the point that we can resolve Radiant Flames on our turn. Alright, let's go ahead and emerge. That's fine, we'll tap those. Alright, getting shriveled, that's fine. We're going to take 7, but then we'll be able to sweep the board. And hopefully stabilize from that point. Alrighty, well, let's start with a pieces of the puzzle. Probably the best thing that we could see here is a Nissa's Renewal. We didn't get it, though. We'll take what was presented to us. Play our Mountain. And Radiant Flames for the full amount. Do still have this Geist Blast here to clean up something they play if it is 2 toughness or less. Limbering Falls is still an issue. And they have been replaced by AI. Again, I don't know if it's that that's them closing their client or just server issues. Could be either. Going to take 3 here. I think I am going to Geist Blast the opponent's face. And we don't have to worry about our things getting countered. So we are going to play our Vexing Scuttler for its full cost. And get back an Explosive Vegetation. Yes. Alright, holding the Lumbering Falls at bay. Our opponent does have 4 cards in hand here now, though. Elder Deep Fiend is a very, very good draw. We are going to Explosive Vegetation. Getting, again, an island and a mountain. And I think we are just going to pass here. Keep this guy back to block, and if they try to do something with it, then we'll emerge Elder Deep Fiend with it. See, they've played 2 spell shrivels so far. They could have more. I think I'm going to... it's a very tricksy situation here, because this 6 damage is enough to kill us. However, if they activate this, then I can emerge Elder Deep Fiend with no worries. So we'll let them go ahead and do that. Continue. Dimensional Infiltrator 2. Okay. That changes things. So now I think the correct play is to surge this and kill these. Confirm. All right, going to 2. A very precarious position to be in, if I do say so myself. All right, so we've got a forest. We also have a Geist Blast in the yard. We can kill our opponent here. So we're going to do that. All right. Rolling Thunder for 7. Targeting them with all of it. We need to leave blue open. Okay. Then we will Geist Blast it. And again, hit them for another 7. And swing for the remainder with the Vexing Scuttler. All right. Let's play one more, shall we? Yeah, we cannot keep this. That's an easy throwback. I think this is keepable. I would like it to be a bit better, but not going to risk. I don't think that a good 6-card hand is going to be better than this 7. Also, want to apologize for any sounds of rain that come through on the recording. It is, well, looks like we're playing against the AI. It has begun a slow and steady downpour here, though at present it's not coming down hard enough that I think I will have to do post-commentary, though if it does get bad or if the audio comes out not up to standards, I will do that. Play our forest. They let off with a meandering river. So we are definitely playing against almost certainly a dedicated blue-white deck. And it looks like it's Spirits. Tattered Haunter. Okay. We could be in trouble here, even against the AI. Spirits is a deck that, much like Simic Tempo, can give us a bit of a headache. Let's play our mountain and go ahead and pilgrimage. Grab some forests. And try to get up to Ulamog mana, shall we? This Radiant Flames is a good card to have in our hand. Though a lot of the Spirits deck is able to be deployed at instant speed. So we have to be aware of that. I'm happy taking 2 damage a turn for a while, though. Second Radiant Flames is not a bad pull at all. We can't quite play Pieces of the Puzzle yet because we don't have blue mana. So we'll just play our land and pass. Looks like it's still just going to be the Tattered Haunter for the moment. Thunderclap Wyvern. Okay, well, we will be Radiant Flamesing on our next turn, most likely. I would hope to get a blue for the second piece of the puzzle, though I also would be willing to double Radiant Flames to kill them. As much as I would hate to do that. Maybe we can take 5 and hold off for one more turn because this is representing our blue mana. Yeah, let's do that. If our opponent has counter spells available to them, then we are in a lot of trouble here. Go ahead and pass back and see just how dead or alive we are. A second Thunderclap Wyvern would be horrible for us here. then we would still need 2 Radiant Flames to kill the board. Would not be surprised at all if our opponent has either a counterspell or something to give these guys indestructible like Archangel Avison or make a stand. Still, we've got to try it. Go for the full boat. Confirm suspicions. All right. Well, we do have enough life to hopefully try again next turn. Going to 5. If we don't get this Radiant Flames to resolve here, we're probably just dead. Barring the drawing of a miracle, which we did not do. So let us play pieces of the puzzle first as a bait spell to see if we can get them to counter that. And we did, so that's good. They did it with Awaken, so that's one more thing to kill. Don't know if a human would have done that, but we're against the AI, so we take what we can get. Even though we've cleared the board, there's no guarantee that we can pull this out. We're still at a very low life total. We do have enough mana, counting the 2 in our hands, to play Ulamog, but it's surviving to get to that point that is going to be difficult. Geist Blast should help a bit anyway. If they flash something in on our instep here, we can try to kill it. But they are sacking clues and drawing cards. There's Rattle Chains. Well, we need to pause the game in response to its giving itself hexproof and kill it. Right, drawing another card. Even casting Ulamog here is no guarantee of winning either, because I'm guessing everything in their deck is flying, and Ulamog is definitely not that. Jaddy Offshoot is good, however, we have to play Ulamog. And so we will, and exile these dual lands. It's looking like Ulamog is going to resolve. There's a Thunderclap Wyvern. So that's just 3 damage off of us being dead. Going to 3 here. And we're getting Declaration in stoned. At least that does give us a clue to try to draw into something else. And a Bygone Bishop. So that is lethal on board for next turn. Pour over the pages. Let's do that first. Okay, well, we want to untap our islands and then discard the Rolling Thunder. I need to do 3 here and 3 here. 2, which is exactly what I've got the mana for, so I can't afford to play Jaddy Offshoot here. So we will be discarding the discarding the Kozilek's Return. Play our island and Rolling Thunder for 6. And the reason this works is when the Thunderclap Wyvern dies, the Bygone Bishop will shrink and have lethal damage on it. Alright, Tattered Haunter, and the threats keep coming and they don't stop coming. Fall of the Titans, good. Let's draw a card first though. Explosive Vegetation, That should give us a nice life buffer here. We will cast that. Grab more islands and mountains. Gain 2 life. And the question is, do I surge this to kill this and deal 3 damage to our opponent? I don't think I do. I think I hold out to see if they're going to deploy more threats. Sacking the clue. Invocation of Saint Traft. Well, then I have to kill that. Do a damage here, do a damage here. It's a 2-for-1 in a way. Got rid of the invocation and the tattered haunter. Alright, well, let's gain a life. We may actually be able to pull this game out, though it's still a bit early to be banking on that. We do have a Geist Blast in the yard. Alright, let's gain some more life and ramp some more lands. Go ahead and get yet more non-green mana. Okay, Nebelgast Herald. That is a threat from the opponent that we cannot deal with at present. Luckily, our life is back up to 8, so there is that. On its own, it's a 4-turn clock. The opponent does still have 4 cards in hand that I'm really beginning to wonder what they are. Well, there's Gideon, so there's one of them. I guess we will have to do something about him rather quickly. Primal Druid. I mean, okay. It definitely blocks. And ramps us, so there is that. So Jaddy can block here. Primal Druid can block Gideon if they do that. So we'll still be taking 2. But Primal Druid will fetch us a basic and thin our deck out a little bit. But they're just making 2/2s. Thunderclap Wyvern. Okay then. Please let me draw a big Eldrazi. Any of them. Going to 3. We're going to be dead on the next turn. If we could top deck an Elder Deep Fiend or a Vexing Scuttler, well, part of the Water Veil helps. So, let's do that with Awaken. And we're going to awaken onto a forest. Tapping that way is fine. We're going to pause and Geist Blast it. Tapping that way is fine. And we will awaken onto a mountain. So the question is, what do we attack? If we attack our opponent's face, and they don't block, they're dead, but that's not going to happen. I think we try to get Gideon off the board. Yeah, we'll attack both at Gideon. We do get 3 turns of this, so hopefully this will be able to whittle through our opponent's stuff. And now We've got this turn to attack and next turn, so they can block 1. 3 sixes are 18, so we actually have the game here. Alright. Well, let's attack. And we will attack the opponent and not Gideon. And the reason we have the game is the 1 extra damage is going to be available through Pilgrim's Eye. Plus, we could top deck something. Yes. Get the last island. And play that island. And we got Elder Deep Fiend anyway. Cool. Well, let's deal lethal. And I do think that we have enough time to do one more game. So let's do that. Not a good hand. Give me something else. Even worse hand, give me something else. That's a bit better. Let's hope we can draw a third land this time for our Pilgrim's Eye. Not get stuck like we did on one of the previous games. Alright, play out our forest. Alright, looks like we're against an aggressive deck. There is a Selfless Spirit hitting the board. Go ahead and correct this graphical glitch there. Alright, still stuck on our two manas. And we're not given the option to block this guy because it has flying and our Primal Druid most definitely does not. Well, our opponent is continuing to make their land drops, lucky for them. Would like to top deck a land, please. And if I could be ever so greedy, please don't let it be one of the two Evolving Wilds. But we didn't. And so it goes. Getting our face beat in by a 2-1 flyer. What a horrible way to go. Oh, well, Henmore Militia Captain joins the fray. We can block it. It could pose other problems later. Thank you very, very much for giving us our third land. Now we can actually begin to do things. Yes, I would. Please give me an island. And it also gives us a blocker for the Selfless Spirit, so it will probably be hanging back if they don't have something to pump it with, or to keep it from dying. But they attack, so they probably have Make a Stand or something similar. I am still going to be blocking. They have Make a Stand, it will kill our Primal Druid as well, ramping us that little bit more. Long road home, okay. That is fine. Come back, little spirit, as a 3-2. Well, we will do what we said we were going to do and go ahead and explosive vegetation. And just as always, a mountain and an island. Next turn, we've got Chandra. So that's good. Though Selfless Spirit puts a little bit of a crimp into that plan. The question is, do I want to save it? The Pilgrim's Eye, that is, to emerge Vexing Shusher with, or not Shusher, Vexing Scuttler with. Let us just block there. I will take the 3. I think I'm going to emerge the Scuttler. Well, there's Kithion's Irregulars, so maybe I should have blocked because I do need to try to wipe the board, even though this doggone spirit is giving us grief over that. Alright, well, Geist Blast helps a bit. Let's see, we've got 7 to emerge this, so we actually can emerge this and Geist Blast. So let's get in a point of damage. Every point matters. Then we will play our island and Geist Blast the spirit. They will probably sack it just to give their stuff indestructible, which is a good play to make. Just in case I have something else to kill the rest of their creatures. Then I will emerge this Vexer, getting our explosive vegetation back. I do want to use the ability. Alright, this Kithion's Irregulars is especially problematic as it can tap our stuff down. Looks like they're not going to tap both down. Just that. Okay. So I don't want it to become renowned, so I will play into whatever combat trick they've got here. Celestial Flare, that is perfectly fine. Because I'm going to play Chandra and wipe the board. Which is good for us because it lets our Primal Druid die. Which is something we actually want to happen. Alright, we will minus Chandra for 3. The fact that this didn't become renowned will allow us to keep her on board. Not have to minus her for the full 4. Yes, I want to use the ability. How dare you even ask? Right, it's looking like the opponent has nothing going on, which is very, very, very good for me. We are going to start by attacking with 2 3-1s. Continue. There we go. Archangel Avison. Well, it's good to know that she's there. Alright, so we'll do 3. Avison will soak up one of the elementals. And then we are going to ramp like that. 1, 2. Confirm. No spell mastery as of yet. Play our land for the turn. And we actually can emerge our Griff. Even though this has no casting cost, it allows us to reduce to the emerge cost, so we're going to do that. That will give us a blocker for Avison and hopefully keep our Chandra alive. Green Warden is good here too. Don't have anything I particularly want to recur right now, but that will not always be the case. Alright, well, our Griff is getting declarationed. So Chandra is going bye-bye after all. I think we're probably going to cast Pieces of the Puzzle this turn. Because we don't quite have enough. Play Green Warden recurring Chandra, then playing her and killing Avison with her. Which actually we may want to cast Pour Over the Pages first. Yeah, let's do that, since it is just raw card draw. Alright, well that's a lot of stuff. Let's untap some forests here. Then we will discard the Primal Druid, I think. And make our land drop. Then I don't know whether to just ramp as hard as we can in anticipation of Pieces of the Puzzling next turn. We're only in danger of taking 4 with what's on board. I think that's what I'm going to do. I think I'm just going to Explosive Vegetation twice and get as many lands out of our deck as we can. You get two islands. And get two mountains, and that's all of the non-forest basics. Hopefully then our pieces of the puzzle can find something worth playing to deal with what we've got facing us here. We could also just recur Chandra with Green Warden and use all of her loyalty to wipe the board. That is, if the opponent doesn't have another make a stand in their hand. Well, there's a Radiant Flames. So let us start with a pieces of the puzzle. And the opponent pausing there makes me believe that they do have some sort of trick in hand, though that may not be the case. They may just be reading the pieces of the puzzle to see what it actually does. Crush of Tentacles gets around all of that, though. So let's take Crush, and we'll also take Fall of the Titans. Confirm. Alright, let's go ahead and Surge Crush. That is fine. Give us our 8/8 octopus. Then we will also cast a Green Warden. I really should have sacked that clue previously, but I didn't bother to count my lands to see if I was able to. So that was a misplay on my part. Recurring our Crush with the Green Warden. And now we're in a position that if they don't remove this Green Warden, we can eternally recur the Crush of Tentacles over and over and over just to deal with whatever they've got on board until we can win the game. Alright, Bygone Bishop. And they should know we have this Radiant Flames in hand. I think anyway, they may not be aware of it. Well, we are going to fetch a forest, because that's all that's left to fetch. So there's four left after this. Then we will Radiant Flames for three. And this should be the game, unless they have something they can do with one white mana. Should take them to two, and then we've got Fall of the Titans to finish it. And we will Surge. Do 10, leave two open. Well, they left the game. And we will target here. Finish. It's kind of a glitch. You can't interact with this until you deal with this prompt here. That's fine. However, you've got it tapped. And that will be it for this episode of Friday Night Magic, friends. I do hope you've enjoyed the video. If you have, please leave a like below. It really does help. If you didn't like it, well, the dislike button's right beside the like button. Consider subscribing to the channel. You'll be notified when I upload new content. And until next time, friends, be excellent to each other.